5 minutes from now, you'll know what hematocrit is, why yours may be low or high, and what you can do to fix it. And along with this video, I'm giving you 2 free resources to help take your health to the next level. Hey, I'm Dr. Tom Schechtsnyder, and I want to help you understand your labs and optimize your health. Because when your health is optimized, you can do anything. Let's go. Hematocrit is a red blood cell test. Hematocrit tells you how much of the total blood volume red blood cells occupy. It's a percent. Pretend this glass of ice water is blood. The ice is the red blood cells and the water is everything else. If I spun this glass down in a centrifuge, the ice would pack in tight to the bottom of the glass. That's hematocrit. It's also known as packed red blood cells. Look at this tube of centrifuged blood. The top layer is plasma, which is over 90% water, but contains proteins, electrolytes, glucose, waste products, and other stuff. The middle layer is the white blood cells and platelets, and the bottom layer is the packed red blood cells, aka hematocrit. You can see normal hematocrit is about 45%, and this can be conceptually measured in 3 ways. The first is by measuring how high the packed red blood cells are in the tube and dividing that by the total height of the blood. I use perfect numbers here to make it easy to see. The second is by multiplying mean corpuscular volume, which is the average size of each red blood cell, times the red blood cell count, and both of these numbers are on the CBC. Average cell size times the number of cells gives us an estimate of how much space those cells occupy, which is hematocrit. The third, by the way, is what's known as the rule of threes, which disregards units, but goes like this. Red blood cell count times 3 equals hemoglobin, and hemoglobin times 3 equals hematocrit. These 3 calculations give us the exact reasons why hematocrit may be low or high. The first cause is changes in plasma volume. Since plasma is over 90% water, dehydration or overhydration will cause the opposite change in hematocrit. Dehydration raises hematocrit, and overhydration lowers hematocrit. The second is changes in red blood cell number or hemoglobin, and this is a direct relationship. Low red blood cells and low hemoglobin cause a low hematocrit. High red blood cells and high hemoglobin cause high hematocrit. Now those are the hypothetical scenarios, so let's learn about the actual causes and how to fix them. Low hematocrit is another way of saying anemia. The most common causes of anemia are iron deficiency 50% of the time, followed by anemia of chronic disease, and then all the other types, like B12 and folate deficiencies, sickle cell disease, thalassemias, bone marrow problems, etc. Hone in on iron deficiency and anemia of chronic disease though, because those are by far the most common. I've linked my iron deficiency guide and the free weight loss checklist in the description to help you cure those causes. High hematocrit is pretty interesting. Dehydration causes it. The cure for that is to drink water. But there's another potentially deadly cause, hypoxia, or low oxygen. When your oxygen is low, the bone marrow is triggered to make more red blood cells, leading to high hematocrit. That's normal in people living at high altitudes where the air is thin, but it's abnormal in everyone else, and is often a subtle hint of the silent killer, sleep apnea. 5 to 10% of people in the world have it, and the biggest risk factor is overweight or obesity. The not so subtle sign, of course, is snoring. Obstructive sleep apnea defines itself. During sleep, the airway is intermittently obstructed, causing periods of absent breathing. It's literally like choking from the inside. This starves the brain of oxygen and triggers the fight or flight response, which in some people happens over and over all night long. This, of course, degrades sleep quality, causing chronic fatigue, but also puts people at higher risk of strokes, heart attacks, and metabolic disease. Studies are mixed, but hematocrit seems to be between 1 to 5 percentage points higher in people with OSA than people without it. So if you're overweight or obese, snore, or have chronic daytime sleepiness, you definitely need to get a sleep study done and download my free weight loss checklist, because untreated OSA has deadly consequences. The final cause of high hematocrit that I'll mention is testosterone use. TRT, like OSA, should only increase the hematocrit a few percentage points, but if you're on TRT, take care of yourself. In addition to hematocrit, the testosterone therapy also requires monitoring of your PSA, cholesterol, blood pressure, and mental health. So if your hematocrit is low, download the Iron Deficiency Guide and check out Lab Story's episode on iron deficiency anemia and anemia of chronic disease. If yours is high, get a sleep study done, download the free weight loss checklist, and if you're on TRT, take your health seriously. Here's to understanding your labs and optimizing your health.